The Philippine Budget Department assures health workers it will try to allocate funding for their special risk allowance. For 2023, only 19 billion pesos was allocated for the allowance of medical workers. The agency is asking for consideration, saying the budget provided for 2023 is limited due to lower revenues.
We will try to get from our program appropriations. Mm-hmm. I think I will have to check po with the DOF and our Treasury if there are additional revenues from the national government.
Okay.
So maybe if we will have po, we will try to allocate funding po. We have to consider po what's happening right now po. While we want po to provide funds for everyone, as a result din po of the pandemic, so lower revenues po. The increase of our budget for 2023 is only 4.9%. We try po to increase the budget of all the departments as we can po. But really, the budget provided for us is really, really small.
The Budget Department has approved the release of over 11 billion pesos for one COVID allowance claims this year. Another 1 billion pesos was earlier approved to cover the unpaid special risk allowance of medical workers. But the figures are still way lower than the total unpaid claims of 64 billion pesos. Meanwhile, groups of health workers are dismayed that the Marcos administration failed to fully resolve their unpaid benefits in its first 100 days. They also point out there were no significant changes made yet in the country's healthcare system.
Wala kaming nakikitang pagbabago dito sa 100 days po ni President Bongbong Marcos. Hindi pa namin masasabi kung ano talaga yung totoong grade niya. Kasi sa ngayon pa ay nakita natin na yung nilabas naman na 1.04 billion ng DBM ay para po ito sa mga utang nila doon sa mga health workers na hindi pa po nakakakuha ng kanilang special risk allowance.
Some doctors, meanwhile, note the president's failure to appoint a health secretary in his first 100 days in office.
Hindi pa natin talaga masyadong mabigyan ng grado si presidente dito sa first 100 days nila dahil unang-una, hindi naman natin pa, wala ka talaga tayong anak ka talaga na Secretary of Health. No? Ang meron lang tayo ay OIC. Therefore, as an officer in charge, syempre we can understand, no? hindi masyado makakakilo si OIC Secretary Berhede. No? So, kasi syempre knowing na OIC capacity lang siya, then malilimitahan siya no? Doon sa pwede niyang gawin.
The resumption of full face-to-face classes in the Philippines still under discussion. Vice President Sara Duterte says they are set to present a report to President Marcos to help him decide if the initial plan of mandating all schools to implement full in-person classes by November should push through. The discussions come amid the recent uptick in COVID cases in the country. But Duterte says the rise in cases can also be attributed to the reopening of establishments and not just schools.
Sa ngayon ay meron pa pong discussions at the cabinet level kung bibigyan pa rin ba ng options ang mga schools with regard to kung anong klaseng distance learning or mag-i-implement ba sila ng blended learning. So meron kaming report na ginagawa ngayon para sa Pangulong Marcos at makapag-desisyon siya kung ano po yung ways forward natin with regard to the options na binibigay natin sa ating mga eskwelahan.
The unemployment rate in the Philippines rises to 5.3% in August. That translates to 2.68 million jobless Filipinos, a slight increase from July's 2.6 million, which was the lowest since the pandemic began. Underemployment also rose from 13.8% in July. It jumped to 14.7% in August, or over 7 million underemployed Filipinos. The higher underemployment rate underscored what analysts have said is an issue of job quality in the country.